still sitting in the car over there watching us. Pretty think you're BBC, Pete.
Aye?
No,
we're
going
to do another walk around. I've got a tour out the top there. Have another walk around, I think. Right, yeah.
This unlikely-looking character is none other than that outrageous eccentric of the rally field, John Webber, a man much respected at steam and stationary engine events. Each year he is personally invited to exhibit one of his beloved stationary engines at the world-famous Great Dorset Steam Fair. He can boast of being an acquaintance of Fred Dibner, the well-known steam engine personality from Bolton. Like Fred, John has not escaped the captive audience of the BBC, where he has been interviewed on his rich knowledge of stationary engines. For this man is truly one of a rare breed of men representing a bygone age, a true engine man. During the winter months, John likes nothing more than to walk the secret lanes and fields of his beloved Hertfordshire home, reflecting on last year's rallies and dream of the forthcoming season.
Very quiet this time of year. There's bugger all going on, really. All the restoration's been done. Just a biding time until the rally season starts.
John is also renowned for his collection of bygone artifacts, which are housed in his workshop at the rear of his home.
I've been collecting tins and memorabilia for about 6 years now, from the rallies, different parts of the country. I've got a few over here I can show you. I'll show the first in this. Particular Castrol tin was issued with the vehicle sold at the time as a free sort of gift sort of thing, you know. Still got the original in here, as a matter of fact. I suppose it's dated around about 1920 to 1930. Bow bells. Very old tin that. Bought that Stour Pane last year, as a matter of fact. Speciality oils made by Langston Jones Smith and Samuel Smith of Bow Common, London. Apparently, this used to have sweet bloomless oil, whichever that is, bloke, I know, but never niff of it. It is very sweet. Don't know what it's used for, as I say, but very interesting tin. Very rare, very collectible that. Coming on to some spark plug tins, another collectible item. Unfortunately, I haven't got the plugs to go with them, but got some very interesting names. Massa, Vimy sparking plugs, all British made, got the prices on the end of them, sort of thing. Lots of Lodge tins. This one's got a price on it, look, £5. Got one or two more over here, the KLG spark plug tin. Nicely shaped one, look. Sphinx, old tractor plug that is. Guaranteed all British. Without time limit, how about that, stamped on the side of it. These Valor 2-gallon petrol cans are what I've painted up myself. Can't really use them because they're rusted out on the bottom, but they make a nice exhibit. They've all been dated on manufacture. This one is dated the 3rd of the 31st, 1931. Nice exhibit, as I say, when they're all painted up and sitting beside your engine. Some are rarer than others. You've got the Anglo Taxi Bus Spirit, that's quite a rare one. Same with the Power Ethel Ethel can. I've got the Power though, I've got the petrol one to go with it. Over here in this corner I've got some old enamel advertising signs. Very expensive to buy nowadays. There's a lot of firms now are sort of copying the originals and selling them off to the blooming Yanks and the Japanese, but these I've picked up mostly at Stour Pane Rally over a number of years. As you see, the old rust is coming on and they've been chipped a lot, but best thing is don't do anything with them, just clean them up. Don't try and paint them up and bodge them up because they look even worse. But just give them a wipe over with methylated spirits or something, just make the old lettering shine up a bit more. Over here, I've only just started collecting these. Cast implement nameplates. I don't know if you can see them. This is a two-horse corn drill. And this is a Phoenix potato sorter. I only picked these up last year, so I've, you know, once they're painted up they make an interesting exhibit. I'll have to keep a lookout for these. At the moment I've got a bit of trouble when you see a 3-horsepower at the top. A bit of bearing, main bearing trouble, so I'm trying to sort that out at the moment. Rolling it in the back. Thank you.
early spring, and John has joined some fellow enthusiasts on a pilgrimage to the Beds and Bucks vintage sale. In past visits here, John has been fortunate to acquire a number of bygone relics, and on one particular occasion he was quick enough to snap up a deal on a Petta Universal stationary engine. The engine is now much rallied throughout the country.
Peter, not much here at the moment, being early morning. Oh. You know, give another hour or so and see what turns up. So barn out a bit, Peter, isn't it?
Bit of a rack, isn't it?
Oh. Yeah. I bought some of it here, Peter. A couple of clips going on an HD lead. 50p each. That was worth coming over for, wasn't it?
A welcome break and a chance to take some refreshments to quench the thirst from hard bargaining.
Thank you.
cut.
That there, John, like Wolsey.
Yeah, Wolsey, Peter, the same as yours.
It's missing by the look of it.
Jim, I noticed you bowing something up there earlier.
Yeah.
What was it as bowing?
It's a starting handle for a Leicester Junior. It's been after one for a while.
Yeah. Is it alright? Will it work alright?
Should be alright, yeah. About the same size.
Yeah. Did you get anything else?
Yeah, I got this two-way switch, petrol paraffin.
Oh, it's brand new, though.
Yeah, it's brand new, yeah.
Well, you start off with paraffin, do you?
You start with petrol and then
yeah,
switch it over to paraffin.
Yeah, but you got something, it's more than I got.
Yeah. Robin.
John!
Yes!
I see your covers on your trailer still, you couldn't have bought anything.
No, I ain't bought nothing today, mate. There's nothing really here, you know, I was after an engine, but nothing came about, sort of thing.
Yeah.
So I'm going back with my wallet full of money still.
Yeah.
And an empty trailer.
Yeah. I see Jim had bought an handle or something and a tap.
That's right, yeah, a couple of bits and pieces, yeah.
I think Simon got some wheels.
Yeah, that's right. I bought a couple of little bits going in to plug on the HT leads.
Yeah.
But that was only a quid, so.
Yeah, okay, we're going back to the money this time.
That's right, mate, yeah.
Hello.
Okay then.
Increasingly less likely now is the chance of finding an abandoned piece of machinery in the wild. So the find you are about to see is indeed a very rare occurrence. On the site of a long abandoned nursery, overgrown and almost unapproachable, a discovery of an old engine brought much excitement at a quiet time of the year.
Where's that nursery, John?
It's over there, Pete,
yeah. All derelict now.
Yeah.
That's where we're going to find it. It's right at the back, yeah.
It's right at the back of those trees, is it?
That's it, yeah.
Have to get over the river somehow.
That's it. There's a fallen tree trunk that's going to be handy to get across.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right. Anyway, I've got my Wellingtons on just in case of falling.
Right.
Okay.
Johnny spotted it yet?
I can see something in that blooming edge here, Pete. Looks like a man co, mate. Open crank,
there.
Yeah?
There's a plate on it.
Yeah?
Have a look.
Looks like it's been there a few years, mate, judging by the rust on it. See the serial number, I've just scraped some lemon rust off it. The serial number up on top there. 122761. That's an early model, isn't it? It's a real old number on it.
That's got to be First World War era, isn't it?
Yeah, easily.
Can you tell me something standing there since then?
That looks blooming mighty seized, doesn't it?
It's been standing there since the First World War, but not surprising.
It's been a good many years when it's had tree climbing through here, hasn't it?
What do you think then?
Well, we have to get it out first, won't we?
Yeah.
Cut the nuts off.
See if we can shift it.
See if we can shift it.
Yeah. It'd be nice to get it back home, wouldn't it? If that's possible.
It don't look too heavy. I think, you know, it's a lighter model.
Yeah. Yeah.
At least it's not a 4 horsepower job. You know,
no.
It's only one, was it 2.25, I think I was in.
Yeah.
Still. Let's get on with it, shall we?
Yeah.
There's something. Been over here. These nuts are coming off pretty easy.
It's moving.
Careful, don't break the casting.
It's still fixing the front though, John, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's probably what's holding it.
I'll go around the front and have a look. Take the Stilsons. Oh dear. Hey, good job we didn't have snow about, Pete.
Well, it's not surprising, John, is it, that it is so bad? If that had 10 years of life, that could have been standing here 60 years derelict.
Yeah. Still, they're working loose. It's turning off. That's sitting on a wood plinth, this here.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's bolted to a wood plinth. I thought it was concrete. All the wood is set into a concrete base down there.
It's moving, John.
It's coming, Pete. Still some water in the hopper, are you?
Well, John, we've made
yes,
it,
Peter.
I reckon.
Yeah,
must have shifted a couple of 100 yards, I should think.
Seems bloody more than that, mate. I bet 2 miles.
gotten a bit of sweat.
Yeah, still we got it back, mate, haven't we?
Yeah.
Come across that bloody swamp over there.
That's it, yeah.
Over that log. We're doing a good clean up with all the mud around it before we put it in the booty car.
Yeah. Right, last hunt, mate.
Okay. Right.
What do you reckon?
Well, these are coming off a rock, Peter. Sure. Still got the bloody grease in then.
Oh, yeah.
Last time that was greased up when? 1917? 18? Before the 20s, wasn't it?
Well, from cleaning some evidence out of that stationary engine mag, it points to that direction, yeah.
Yeah, that one's alright. The old thrust block's gone, look, the gears are rusted away. I'll bet those bearings are still alright, then. Get it unseized.
There's no mag on it.
No mag, that's been busted off.
Yeah.
Valves are gone for Burton and all, new valves on it. Drip feed oiler, Peter. Comes off alright.
That'd be brass, John, wouldn't it?
Yeah, brass in brass, that comes out right.
We're close, look at that.
Lubricates the piston.
Still got the glass intact.
Yep. Good clean up, that come out lovely, wouldn't it? Beautiful, eh? Completely knackered, isn't it? That's where the exhaust went, the silencer, that's completely rocked away. Valve springs, as you can see, gone. Valves are knackered.
Still a bit of the spring left though, aren't there?
Yeah, but it, yeah. Look at that, look, it's
disintegrated.
Disintegrated. Well, to sum it up, Pete, he's dropping in a 40-gallon can of diesel oil paraffin for then about a year to free all these rusted nuts off. Perhaps be able to do something with it.
Yeah, I think you're about right, John.
Yeah.
Fortunately, on stripping down the engine, it became clear that its condition was well past its sell-by date. The piston was well seized, not shifting at all, under various attempts to part it from the cylinder. It now adds interest to a flower border as an example of a bygone relic. It's the first rally of the season for John here at Lambourne Spring Workings, and he's been fortunate enough to obtain another petter to add to his collection of petter engines.
Another one for the collection. You don't know the year this, mate, do you? I was made a bit of late 20s.
The old boy was 28 or 29.
Yeah, it's awful bit of late 20s, yeah. Yeah, because they phase them greases out when about 30s, beginning of the 30s. The old oil bath's come into being.
The rally season takes John and his family to the far corners of the country. Distant events such as St Agnes in Cornwall, Stourpan in Dorset, Netley Marsh near Southampton, and at Parham Park, Sussex, are regular visits each year. Thank you.
John's expertise on stationary engines were put to the test at the Wyborney Rally near Stevenage. A film crew chose him for an interview on the subject. And here at Low Ham in Somerset, he was given the opportunity to steer a steamroller. August, John was invited to show one of his engines at the Mill Green Mill and Museum with a few other enthusiasts.
What's going on here then?
Well, it's an open day at the Mill Green Museum, Peter, just outside of Wellingarden City. Home day for stationary engines and tractors and old farm implements. Very nice Sunday afternoon's rally. It's more like a get-together really than a rally, you know.
This present-day mill, built in the 17th century, stands on the site of one of four Hatfield mills listed in the Domesday Book. The buildings have been reconstructed and altered many times in its history. By the early years of the 20th century, it was becoming increasingly difficult to make a living from the mill, and in 1911 it closed down. After an interval of 75 years, milling recommenced after a complete restoration programme. Outside in the mill's garden, the gathering of engines create great interest to the visiting public. At this event, John had brought a small part of his collection of enamel signs and tins as an added interest to his exhibit. Today John is at the Roxton Park Rally in Bedfordshire. This is one of the last events of the season.
This book for years, Street Jewellery, with the main subject is enamel advertising signs, you know? So I should go back and have a read of that. Smashing book.
John has brought his Petter Universal engine. New for this year is the attached Victorian governor weight assembly. This was part of an early lift break and attracted much attention to a bewildered public. Rally season over, John retired back into his workshop.
As you may remember, this is the engine I purchased at the Lambourne Spring Workings in last May. It's now at the end of September, so I'm starting restoration. Got a fair amount with it, got a fair bit off. The only thing that's going to cause a problem is this here key at the flywheel. We always get one awkward one. I got the other one off all right, but I've got to think about doing this one. I might have to drill it, so you have to see what happens. I managed to paint this up the other day, a silencer and exhaust pot. It's come up quite well. Got heat resistant black paint on it. And actually this is the first time I was happened to get this drain plug out. Look at that, it comes out very easy. That's for draining out the accumulations and bits of old oil and God knows what else. Normally that's welded in by rust and heat and God knows what else, but that's practically dropped out. How smashing that is. I always like to be a bit different from anyone else. Look at these marvellous old wheels I picked up. Pick these up at Parham Steam Rally. I reckon these buggers would take the weight of a 10 horsepower Crossley, let alone a 1.5 horsepower Petter M-Toy. Lovely wheels. I think they must have come off of some sort of bind or some sort of farm implement anyway. They look nice when all painted up red. Right, eye catcher.
The occasion of a cousin's wedding is an event which requires John to exchange his cloth cap and engine jacket to a more refined outfit, causing much discomfort. There is now time for other leisurely pursuits, such as a stroll in the country in this close season of rally events.
What about walking? I like to look in the ditches and the hollows to find any old bits of old metal. It's amazing what people don't really, you know. I like to use this sort of thing with restorations. See what I can find this morning.
Of Anglia, Dad.
Bit of old wood.
Yeah. Isn't it? Yes. Try that out. We'll take that with us. I'm going to say a bit of old angle on it. A bit of old iron. I don't get that there, will we? Is it clipped on there? Screwed on the track. Let's get a little tug back to come out. Oh, blimey. It's coming handy if we can get it. Can you? Oh, like that. I think I need a. Shall I get on the end, Dad?
Yeah, there's a screw over there, it'll break.
It's probably a rusty old screw there. That's a handy piece, look.
Yeah,
come in for an axle block. I should have brought a little junior axle with me.
cut through.
Also down here, a bit of old water pipe. God, that's right, eh? That'll come in as an axle, that will. 7/8 for water pipe. Lovely. What's on the back of this old trailer? Old oak post behind there by the look of it. Oh, I knew that's a rum old size. And that's 6x6, I think. There's a bit more up there. You got it? Oh, that's right, yeah. That's a good old bit there, isn't it? Domestic rubbish here, really. At least we've got some anyway.
Yeah.
Water pipe. Right. I still want some metal plate though, if I can find some. Somewhere in a 8th inch metal plate or something like that.
The end of February, and it's restored, as you can see. running beat through as well, eh?